सर्वैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो तत्व विवेक भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर मोस्ट रेस्पेक्टेबल वैष्णव अवर सोल ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू रैलिश एंड प्रोपेगेट इन नेचर ऑफ शुद्ध भक्त एंड टू लॉर्ड Therefore, our foremost duty is to understand the true nature of Shuddha Bhakti. This understanding will benefit us in two ways. Knowing the true nature of Shuddha Bhakti will dispel our ignorance concerning topic of the Bhakti, and thus make our human life successful by allowing us to release the nature derived from engaging in Shuddha Bhakti in its pure form. And secondly, it will enable us to protect ourselves from the polluted and mixed conception which currently exist in the name of Shuddha Bhakti. We have seen that so many disciples of Swamiji, lacking of good association, bona fide Vaishnava association, they thought like this, this mixed bhakti, this thought that it is pure bhakti. Thus, some of them are propagating mayavad, that if there is bhed and abhed both, if what bhed
Difference and non-difference.
Then Jiva Goswami and all our Chaitanya Mahaprabhu
He took sannyas from Keshav Bharati, sannyas, not name and diksha. Also, Madhvacharya took sannyas from any Mayavadi sannyasi. Sarup Damodar was in line of that. They think, and there is no harm that we are taking the philosophy of Shankaracharya and Bodhism. They are taking this and telling frankly now. So many, not so many, some of them. Only lacking of association. So we should know what is Mayavad, what is mixed bhakti or adulterated bhakti. We should know karma mishra, jnana mishra, tapa mishra, all these things we should try to know. And then we can make Shuddha Bhakti, otherwise not. Unfortunately, in present day society, in the name of Shuddha Bhakti, various types of mixed devotion, such as Karma Mishra. I told what is karma, what is jnana, what is yoga, and also I told what is karma mishra. Karma mishra are of also two kinds, where karma is some prominent and somewhere bhakti is prominent. Karma pradhan bhakti and bhakti pradhan karma. Bhakti pradhan karma is somewhat better than that. They have chance that they can be rectified. Similarly, what is karma? What is karma? What is karma?
All activities that are meant for the senses, satisfaction of the person.
Fruitive actions. The fruit. I am doer of that work of karma. And the fruit I will taste. Then it will be karma. When I am thinking that I am also Brahma, but now, anyhow, I have been covered with Maya, and when I will go, I will be Brahma. I am Brahma still now at that time. And they think that world is mithya,
false.
And they want salvation, mixing in Brahman. This is jnana. And jnana mishra bhakti, they are chanting name of 24 hours. They day and night, no sleep in night, and chanting Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare. They will never tell Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna. Or same thing. Their Sachidananda Bhagavan, Sat means, Chit means, Gyan, Sachit Ananda. There are not three things, only one thing. There is no misery, nothing. Only ananda, ananda. But what is that ananda? Zero. So, this is jnana. And Gyan Mishra Bhakti, they are chanting, remembering, worshipping also Krishna, Radha also. All they are doing, only for salvation, mixing in Brahma. These are Gyan Pradhan Bhakti. No, they know that by easily they can have salvation. They can mix in Brahma very easily by chanting name. Because Kali Yuga is Yuga Dharma. So by easily, what by stories of lakhs and lakhs births, and only in some days by chanting Krishna name, they will immersed in Brahma. So why not adopting this method? So they are adopting method to reach their goal, that is Saiyuja Mukti. This is Gyan Pradhan Karma.
Bhakti.
And Bhakti Pradhan Gyan, Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma Nasochati Nakangchati Samasarvesh Bhuteshu Madhbhaktim Labhate Param. They have not offended Srimad Bhagavatam, not any devotees. Brahma Bhuta, the six virtues that Atma has no birth and death, nor sorrow and suffering. These are all for body. And two more. Apahat papma bijaro
bishako
bijighato
apipasa.
All these are having this. Brahmabhuta prasannatma, always happy. Always happy. If any problem comes, oh, it is for body, not for atma. Not wanting anything, worldly desires. And they are equal to all. These virtues are there. But they have also some consideration for Bhagavatam, Gita, some bhakti. Not offending. Then, if by luck they have an association of pure bhakta, like Sanakshandan Sanatan, they have so much faith in his father,
Brahma.
And by their association, at once he gave up all these things.
Sukadeva Goswami was of this type?
Sukadeva Goswami was also like, somewhat like this. First, there are two Sukadeva.
Yeah.
In other Purans, Sukadeva Goswami, he went to Janakpuri there, and he took some instruction from
Janak.
He was not the same Suk. This Suk, the son of Vyas, he at once went to forest, and Vyasdev strictly called him, and he read Srimad Bhagavatam with Vyasdev. He is separate. The another Suk who went to Janakpuri, it is told in other Jug.
Kalpa.
In this Kalpa, this Sukhdev is another, and another Kalpa before that. That Sukh was, who came to Janakpuri and quite naked, and he wanted to go enter in the palace of Maharaj Janak to have some teaching from him. But Janak told his gatekeeper, there were about 7 gates, one after another. So first gatekeeper, he told that you should stop him for 7 days there. Don't tell him to take anything. No reception, nothing. Don't allow him to sit anywhere. He can sit anywhere. And the 7 day he was there. After that, he entered in second. There also 3 days he was checked. No honor, nothing. Thus checking. When he came on the last gate, oh, so many young ladies, very beautiful. So many, with garland, with so many things. And they received him with dance and kirtan. But he was like an sukha hua lakdi, dry wood, nothing. They were 3 days taking Sukadev Goswami dancing and singing, but no effect. After that he was sent to the council of Maharaj Janak. There Narada Rishi was sitting, and Janak was not on the throne but near the little feet of Narada Rishi. When he went, at once all were stood up, and they honorably, Maharaj Janak took Sukadev Goswami and made him seated on one side of the throne, and Narad was sitting on one end of that. And he went inside his palace and told his very, very beautiful wife, too young and too beautiful, the mother of Sita, you know, how beautiful. And he told that you should decorate yourself with 16 kinds of singar. Singar means?
Decorations.
And she became more beautiful. And then he brought her there, and he told that you should sit in the middle.
Between of Narad and Sukadev.
One side Narad and one side Sukadev Goswami naked. And she came also decorated. And she at once sat between them. Then Sukadev Goswami, nothing to do, like dry wood, always remembering Brahma. And Narada Rishi, he saw this beautiful queen of Maharaj Janak, and he did pranam to her, and he left the seat, and he sat on ground.
Lower down.
So Sukadev Goswami was that, always. But anyhow, by the association of Vyasadeva, he was turned into very pure bhakta. But we see that any Vaishnava has not turned to Mayavadi. Never he has become. Never. Ramana was Mayavadi. Kumbhakarna was Mayavadi. Meghnad was Mayavadi. Also, this Hiranyakashipu was biggest Mayavadi. All the demons are Mayavadi. But some of them has been turned. But any Vaishnava have never been turned to Mayavadi. Shankaracharya defeated so many learned persons, but not any of Vaishnava. He defeated only Karmi, some Jnanis, some others, Bodhism, but not any of Vaishnava. He made so many explanation of so many books, but he wanted to write something about Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhashya. But he was ordered that you should not touch. He went to Varanasi. He was coming to Vrindavan. Never we have heard that he came to Vrindavan. Never. Oh, you should be there. He wanted to go to Navadvip, but he was warned, oh, don't go there. So Mayavad is a very dangerous thing. If it will come in any Vaishnava or Vaishnavi or Bhakti will go, and it will go uprooted. So we should know that what is Mayavad, and we should try to be very careful for Mayavad. Also, karma is very dangerous, but not harmful like Mayavad. The theory is that we should think, I am not doer and tester of our karma. So in the beginning, we should try to offer our fruits of all karms to Narayan. But when a pure devotee, we will associate with any pure devotee, then we should know that we are eternal servant of God, Krishna. But not a comparison. Here, eternal servant means like a son, like a friend in Vrindavan. He thinks that if I am servant of God, Krishna, then my everything is of Krishna, my body also. And if family person, then his wife, his children, his husband, his home, his everything is of Krishna. So he is not master of anything. And if he has something separate, then he is not servant. That is why Prahlad Maharaj has told, first offer yourself and become him, and then you should do anything. Then it will be bhakti, shramanam, kirtanam, vishnu, smaranam. Otherwise, you have not offered yourself, your body, your soul, your senses, your whole properties, your wife, your son. Oh, something I am doing, and something among of all these things, I will give some fruit. Very delicious food, any mango. Oh, Gurudev, I am giving you. This is a very little part. I am donating Gurudev 10,000 of pound or
dollars.
It may be that it will be the very small part of his whole property. But giving, it means you are giving some little, not you have given yourself, or something is with you. So only some fruits are giving. So it is karma mishra. And karma pradhan, karma prominent. Karma prominent. So we should try to know karma. And its fruits all should be karma also, myself also, my karma, everything. Then everything will be done for Krishna. Whatever you do, do for Krishna. For the help, for to please Krishna or to benefit of Krishna and devotees. Then it will be no karma. Very hard to do, easy to say. Easy to say, but very hard And if you are doing, then at once liberation, at once, quickly, no delay of 1 second, liberation is there. No attachment then. Then having some honor for all these things and doing for Gurudev and Vaishnava. I remember that in my Brahmachari Jeevan, in my Brahmachari life, Gurudev was penniless person. He never went to beg anything anywhere. What easily coming? Anyhow, passing his days, always chanting, remembering and preaching like this. So when we came, we saw that there is nothing to cook, nothing to do, anything, no vessels, no pots, nothing, no one single chair in mat, nothing. What we will take in evening, in night, there was nothing. So we thought that we should try to go to Vague somewhere. So I never knew how to beg. I was like a police officer, so many servants with me, and so many police constable always serving so much. So I never did so, but I used to go. And very morning, at about 6, on foot, 5 miles, 6 miles, 10 miles, 12 miles, sometimes in rail. And very hardly whole day up to 6 to 6, 12 hours. 5 rupees, 6 rupees. 5 rupees and 12 anas. 12 anas, you know?
0.75.
How to complete 6 rupees and then used to go up to Gurudev. Anywhere? Can you give me some pies?
Borrow from somewhere.
Borrow. And completing 5, so fraction, and to 6, and he used to. Guru Maharaj used to take, and I have never had any amount from anyone. And he used to give us inspirations. We have never had any pies in our pocket. Whatever he used to do for him, up till now, I never thought that this is mine and I should give this to this. Never. Everything, what I have for Krishna and for Gurudev. And that is why he has so mercy to me. I realize this and sometimes I weep for this. How they have merciful to me that anything reading, at once going so deep, and my never any doubt. So we should all try to be like that. If you are a householder, Mahaprabhu has allowed something, concession, that you can have something for maintenance of your family. But brahmacharis, not. Those who are brahmacharis are mathabhashi, always engaged in these things. Then we can realize all these things, otherwise not. In Grihastha also, we should be like Pandavas, like Srinivasacharya, like Rai Ramananda,
Srivas Pandit,
and like all these things. And then you will feel that, very easily, we are advancing. Unfortunately, in present day society, in the name of Shuddha Bhakti, various types of mixed devotion, such as Karma Mishra, mixed with fruitive action, Gyan Mishra, mixed with
speculative
knowledge, and Yoga Mishra, What is yoga? Now, yoga is not like Gita. Yoga means what? Plus.
Union.
Union. There must be two things. One soul and one Krishna, God Himself. And if they are added,
connected,
how they will be connected? With bhakti. Yeah. Then this is called bhakti yoga. When? Karma yoga. When all karmas, all activities will be added to Krishna, then it will be karma yoga. You are giving, you are doing so many things, and its fruits you are giving to Krishna. Then it is karma yoga. But when you are becoming of your Gurudev and totally
surrender,
then all your karmas, all the fruits are of Krishna. This is bhakti, pure bhakti, not karma yoga. But when you are only adding something to Krishna, for Krishna, and something for you, then it will be karma yoga, offering your fruitive karmas and fruits.
Kama Mishra, bhakti kama yoga same.
Yeah. Like patram pushpam phalamatoyam na
jat karosi
jadasnasi jadjahosi tajastap. Jat kon tapasyasi kaunteya purut samad arpanam. Like this arpanam. This is karma mishra. Dhru was of this karma mishra bhakti. Karma mishra bhakti. Prahlad Maharaj was?
Gyan.
But he is not like this. He was Shuddha Bhakta. But he is called Jnani Bhakta, not Karma Mishra, Gyan Mishra Bhakta.
Jnani Bhakta.
Not like this. Yoga Mishra. Yoga Mishra means by sam, dam, niyam, asan, pranayam, dhyan, dharana, dhruvanusmriti, and samadhi. That is patanjal. This is yoga. No need of Ishwar. No need of Ishwar. They don't deny. And sometimes they accept Ishwar, but what is Ishwar? Or all the fruits of karma now has become Ishwar, and by this Ishwar, sukh and dukh, happiness and
distress
is coming. We are controlled by that. And that is called apurva. The fruits of all karmas are apurva, and he is Ishwar, and according to our fruits, we are having so much birth, death, suffering, sorrows, sometimes happiness, and all these things. But really, this is not yoga. In Gita, Gita, it has been told, yogi are so higher of rank. What yogi? First, you should be nishkarma, offering everything to Krishna. And then you should remember, or you should entrance see Paramatma. And then there will be a link between Paramatma and Jivatma, and this is called yoga. But this yoga If we are surrendering, like Vyas first, and then we are remembering, then it will be bhakti. That pure bhakti. And Krishna will be realized. But not by this yoga. Dhyan, dharana, samadhi, dhruvanu, smriti, and all these things. So, sometimes, some devotees do like this. But for us, we don't require to do anything. From beginning, chanting, remembering, and giving ourselves everything, totally surrendering. So, first, we will have to do surrender ourselves without any gain. So in Gita it has been told, sarva dharmana prityajya mam ekam saranam braja aham tvam sarva papebhyo mokshayishyami mas. As well as various polluted and imaginary conception are spreading everywhere like germs of plague. Now we have no plague. I've heard that if any is one is patient in the whole village, one house affected by plague, quickly they used to give up that village. Because in some moments they can be attacked all. But now you are not saying. So these are more dangerous than plague. Now going spreading everywhere all these things. People in general consider these polluted and mixed conceptions to be bhakti. They think that this is bhakti. Some are thinking that Mayavad is also bhakti. Because achanta bheda bhed, abhed also. So they think that. Mayavadi also think that we are bhakta because offering flowers, offering preparation, so many things, also doing arati. What we do, Shuddha Bhakta, they follow all these things. But they want
Moksha.
To march. And bhakta, nothing. Nothing. So far difference. Even the gurus, like Kul Guru, you know?
Family Guru.
They think that we are bhakta. They may be bhakta, some of them, but not all. But they think that we are Shuddha Bhakta. But by associating them, or taking mantra from them, zero will come. Nothing. So, Vipra kiva nyasi sudra keno nai jai krishna tattavetta se. Anyone knowing all these things, whether he can be sudra, very wretched class of person, any class, jati, he can be Hapsi of Africa, he can be
scheduled caste
of India, or anyone like Vidur or anyone, but he is Guru. The polluted and mixed concepts are our greatest enemies. Some people say that there is no value in bhakti, that God is an imaginary sentiment only. So many. God is nothing. Only a sentiment that God is there. Vivekananda in our country, he is thought to be a very high class of realized soul. But he is in that category. Sentiment. We prefer to play football than to
read to Gita.
To read Gita or going and worshipping any deity. So these are all in the man has merely created the image of God in his imagination. So God is nothing. Like Buddha, how he became like this? His father, mother have so much belief in God. They used to worship God. And he was in a Kshatriya family. Kshatriya, you know?
Administrative class.
Kshatriya family. But he went to, once when he was of 16 years of age, prince, he told that, I want to go to see my village or my kingdom anywhere. The king knew that he is very soft-hearted person, boy. He told his minister that you should take him with you and you can go and show my kingdom. So they were in a very good chariot and they were going. When he came from his palace, anywhere a baby has taken birth, and he was he was weeping so much. What is this? Why he is weeping? Oh, he has taken just birth, and he is so thankful way. He has just come out from his mother's womb, and so he is weeping so much. He went on, and then he saw that there some were boys were playing football and all other things. What? Who are they? Oh, the same boy has become like this and playing football and all that. Then he saw that some band was going on, and so many persons follows a palkiwala.
Palanquin.
And very
decorated.
A boy was there of 24 years. And a girl was with him. What is this? Oh, now he has become matured in age and they have been married. After that, he saw an old man. Who is this? Oh, the same who was
married.
No. Who took birth and that he became some bigger. And after that, he was married and now he has become old. No remedy. He will have to be old. Oh, I will also be old like him? Oh, yes. And after that he went and he saw that four persons were taking anyone on a bamboo
bed.
And telling Ram Ram Satya Hai, Ram Ram Satya Hai. No? Ram Nam Satya Hai Mane? All this world is like this. Only suffering and sorrow, dying and taking birth. Now only Ram Nam, Krishna Nam is only
true.
And everything is like this. Don't be engaged in all these things. He told her, what is this? Oh, so many are crying and weeping and taking, what is this? Oh, the same boy who was married and who became old. Now you are seeing that all were weeping and he has left his body. What is this? Oh, I want to return just now. Then he was returned. The Prime Minister told him, his father, oh, he has returned just now. And he is upset. And in the midnight, anyone could not see him where he has gone. He left his home, father, mother, everything, and he went. What is reality? What is truth? What is all are in distress and suffering. So I should be in trance. And he went to Gaya. Gaya, you know, the birthplace of Vishnu Buddha Dev. And there, in the peepal tree sat, and he sat in ocean. If there is any God, he should come in my trance, and he should tell me that what is true, what is truth. I am saying that this body is not truth because it was transferred to so many stages and this body went away. So it must not be true. Then what is true? Anything in this, in him, what is that? If God or soul is here, then it must be realized. So he sat for so many days like this. But nothing came. Nothing came. Then he told that, oh, God is zero, world is zero, from zero everything has come, and at last we will have to mix in zero. Nothing, all these things. Why it became? Vyasadeva saw in his trance, you know, he saw that Purnam Madah, Purnam Idam, Purnata Purnam Uddachyate, Purnasya Purnam Eva.
Adaya Purnam Eva.
He saw the Purna Purush, Krishna, his all associates, Nandava, Yashoda, Srimati Radhika, Lalita, Vishakha, Sridham, Subal, and whole Vrindavan Dham, Brajamandal he saw. And he saw that those who are forgetting Krishna, they are going down in this world. And those who are taking shelter of Gurudev, pure bhakta, and taking shelter of Krishna, they are again, not again, they are serving Krishna and they are going to Vrindavan or Vaikunth. And seeing this, he manifested Srimad Bhagavatam. Bhagavat was before him. This is prayer to Narad, Vyas, Brahma. Because Brahma has realized this. Four shloki Bhagavat, Srimad Bhagavat. So eternal this. Gita and Bhagavat are eternal. Not new thing that Vyasadeva composed it in letters, nothing. He realized only, transcendental thing. Because he surrendered himself and he followed bhakti yoga, so Krishna came in his
trance.
But he was not surrender soul, this Buddha. Gautam Buddha, not surrender soul. How Krishna will come? He will never come in lakhs and lakhs trance, he do. So never come, and he thought like this. So this is called Shunyavad. So he also thought that this is what I am doing, it is all right. And now from this Kevaladvaitvad, the theory of Shankaracharya came. Shankaracharya is also in this line, somewhat
difference
outwardly, not inwardly, no difference.
Internal,
external. So it is very dangerous. He has told one thing, that these polluted and mixed conceptions are our greatest enemy. Some people say that there is no value in bhakti, God is an imaginary sentiment only. That man has merely created image of a God in his imagination, and the bhakti is just diseased state of consciousness which cannot benefit us in any way. But these persons telling like this, they are not our so greatest enemy. Who is enemy? Who are telling that we are devotee? but not truly fallen devotee. The enemies from outside, they cannot do anything so much harm, but the enemies of our home, they will do more harm to you. So they are enemies in our home, like rats in our home, always cutting cloths here and there. It is very, we can be very careful from tigers, where they cannot easily come to our home, our homes, but they are always leaving our home and cutting so many things. So, क्या बाहर के शत्रु हमारे उतने अधिक शत्रु नहीं हैं?
Outdoor enemy is not so great enemy, but indoor enemy.
But जो हमारे अंदर के शत्रु हैं, वो हमारे अधिक शत्रु हैं. कौन? जो ये कहते हैं, those who tell that we are bhakta. Sometimes doing like as bhakti, but not bhakta. So he is telling. These types of people, though opposed to bhakti, cannot do much harm to us because we can easily recognize them and avoid them. But those who propagate that Bhagavad Bhakti is the highest dharma, yet behave against the principles of Shuddha Bhakti and also instruct others against the principles of Shuddha Bhakti can be especially harmful to us. What I told?
You said that those who are preaching...
Time is over. अभी नौ साढ़े छः साढ़े ग्यारह बजे आए साढ़े दस बजे चलो.
Those who are preaching Mayavad philosophy, Buddhist philosophy, other types of philosophies opposed to bhakti, and you can see them externally that they're not so harmful as those who come in the dress of devotees and they're posing like devotees. And they are preaching a philosophy that they're presenting to be Shuddha Bhakti, but actually it is not Shuddha Bhakti, and they're actually cheating and misdirecting so many people that those people that they are the greatest enemies.
Yeah.
So Mayavadi is also one of them. Hmm? They are inside the people.
No, we can you can recognize
Mayavadi Raj outside enemy. We can recognize them easily because they are ek dandi. They don't take tilak, they don't take mala, they don't read Bhagavatam, they don't follow Bhakti Yoga. So we can recognize that he is Mayavadi. But those who are taking tilak, mala also.
Pretendent.
Hypocrites.
Yes.
Hypocrites.
Like Baba.
But the Mayavadi who have adopted Bhakti also, they are difficult to recognize.
You should hear.
It's more than hypocrite.
Yes.
Because hypocrite just says, I am something, but I'm not something.
It is very hard to recognize them in the shape of Vaishnava. He is telling. Therefore, with great endeavor, our previous acharyas have defined the swarup or intrinsic nature of bhakti and have repeatedly cautioned us to keep ourselves away from the polluted and mixed concepts. We shall deliberate on their instruction in sequence. They have compiled numerous literatures to establish the swarup of bhakti, like Ji Goswami. Rupa Goswami has written so many books and he never dealt with all these things, karma, yoga, jnana, bhakti. Only Shuddha Raganuga Bhakti, Swarup Siddha Bhakti. Especially the bhaktis of gopis. Especially. He has not quoted the arguments of Mayavadi and all these things. He was so far away from these things. But Jig Goswami saw that now so many persons in the disguise of devotees, and they are spreading all these things like plague. So he wanted to make two sides so
strong and hard concrete,
like Ganges should go on and no pollution should come. That is why his all the books, like Sat Sandarbha, Sar Sambhadini, and other books are like pakka,
concrete wall,
so that this should not come. And Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur and all other acharyas have accepted and taken the essence of these things in Jaiva Dharma and so many books. So there are three kinds of bhakti: Sarup Siddha Bhakti, then Sangha Siddha Bhakti, and Arop Siddha Bhakti. Though it is very not so hard, we think, but we should try to know. If you are not knowing, then your idea will be change of bhakti, and you can be karmi, mayabadi, and not Shuddha Bhakta. So we should try to know also. And in evening I am giving classes of Srimad Bhagavatam. Especially, we have 14 days here and
Bejar.
I think that most of our devotees will go also to Bejar. So, no hurry, in 14, 15 days, I want to speak the whole Srimad Bhagavatam in brief. But I want to tell something, most important things of Srimad Bhagavatam. I know that I have begun in Mathura Srimad Bhagavatam. Now it is 54 years I am there. But I could not complete one time even Srimad Bhagavatam. When I begin one chapter, even Brihad Bhagavatam, it is like Srimad Bhagavatam, explanation of Srimad Bhagavatam. I never completed it. Only one chapter, two chapter in a year, bas. And now I am going to whole world. Now I have no time. I wanted to repeat all these things, but could not. But I will try to speak on some pastimes of Krishna, especially in Braja. But I will touch all the important pastimes of whole Srimad Bhagavatam from beginning to end. But I know that I cannot complete, but anyhow I will try to touch. And new some things you will taste in that. And you will really, if you are hearing all this very patiently, you will know that what is bhakti and how we should do bhakti, pure bhakti, and especially of Braja Bhakti. Gaur Pramanandi. Any kirtan?
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna.